Shanmugam sir, our honorable president engineer ACS Arun Kumar sir, our honorable secretary Thiru A. Ravi Kumar sir, for their constant motivation and consented to conduct the program. I welcome our vice chancellor Dr. Geeta Lakshmi ma'am, former vice chancellor of Dr. MGR Tamil Nadu Medical University. I am pleased to welcome the most eminent speaker of today's webinar, Professor R. Harihara Prakash sir, principal and at KM Patel Institute of Physiotherapy, Vaikaka University, Sri Krishna Hospital Research Center, Gujarat. We are waiting to listen to your lecture, sir. I extend my warm welcome to our principal, Dr. C.V. Sendalnathan, sir, and vice principal, Dr. Veena and Dr. Radhalakshmi, ma'am. And I'm delighted to welcome all the faculty members and the participants connected. Thank you.
Now I invite our principal sir to address the gathering.
Thank you, Deepthi. A very good morning to one and all present today for the wonderful guest lecture on More with Less, Drivers for Best Physiotherapy Clinical Practice by a person with a big caliber, none other than Professor R. Harihara Prakash, principal and head, KM Patel Institute of Physiotherapy, Gujarat. I warmly welcome you, sir, on behalf of Faculty of Physiotherapy, students and staff members. An institution's strength doesn't lie in its infrastructure. The strength really lies in its human resources, who are none other than the students and the faculties. And I'm very proud to say that we have a very good strength. All of our faculties are very eminent in their respective fields, and we have a very good student strength. With them, we have reached wonderful heights, both in academic activities as well as in extracurricular and sports activities. So I don't want to take much of your time. I warmly welcome for this guest lecture. And for a brief note, the whole world is lying still because of the pandemic situation. And for the past, the whole academic year has been gone only with the online classes. Everything has been done in online exams, practicals, as well as the theory exams. So we don't know what is going to happen tomorrow, but we have hope. We have hope that everything will be all right in a short span of time, and we'll be out to see the world as before. So with this positive note, I warmly welcome today's resource person, Professor R. Harihara Prakash, to deliver his guest lecture on More with Less, Drivers for Best Physiotherapy Clinical Practice. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I would like to call Dr. Vaishnavi, Assistant Professor, Faculty of Physiotherapy, to do the introduction on the guest speaker of the day.
Good morning, everyone. It's my tremendous honor to introduce our eminent speaker for today's event. We are indeed privileged to have a noted educationist, Professor Harihara Prakash, Principal and Head, Department of Physiotherapy, KM Patel Institute of Physiotherapy, Baikar University, Gujarat, as our guest speaker. Sir has completed UG in Pondicherry Central University in the year 1997, PG in Dr. MGR Medical University in the year 2001, and doctorate in physical therapy in National University of Medical Sciences, Spain in the year 2015. He has guided more than 200 research projects and also published scholarly works in various national and international journals. He has awarded Rashtriya Vidya Saraswati Puraskar Award for excellent contribution in the field of academics. Sir has received numerous awards for his contribution in the field of physiotherapy, which includes IAP Oration Award, Award for Academic Excellence, Dr. M.G. Mokashi's Professional Excellence Award, and PhysioPride. Dr. Harihara Prakash sir has also made a mark in education and has delivered lectures and conducted workshops in NDT, sensory integration, MET, neurodynamics, childbirth education, Pilates, manual therapy, modified osteopathy, and chiropractic as a resource person in various parts of the country. It's a great pleasure to welcome you for this session, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. I invite the speaker of the day, Professor Harihar Prasad. So the gathering is all yours.
Thank you so much. Thanks a lot. It is always a pleasure to interact with students, to faculty, and that too people from my hometown. So ellarkum vanakkam, namaskaram ellarkum. I'm very happy to address this glorious audience. At the outset, let me first take this privilege to thank Dr. MGR Deemed University, Professor Dr. Sendil Nadan, and especially Dr. Rajalakshmi, who has been the key person to connect between this two forums, and all those who are present in this platform, and the one who introduced me to the audience. Okay, thanks for the kind words. And it is always a back home feeling when I address my own people from my state, Tamil Nadu and Pondicherry. Can I try and share my screen if I'm given the host ship? Let me just check before I start.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Dharni, sir will be able to share the screen, right?
It is disabled. You have to make me the host.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Noted. I think till the time I'm being made as a host, let me continue talking to you as the time is limited. It is always said in English, you know, a well begun is half done. That sense, we have begun it very well. I'm so excited and glad that we are 3 in short of 500. We have 497 participants, which is a very good number. That shows the amount of academic integrity that your institute has, and the involvement of the faculty, and altogether the students who are following the footsteps of their principal, teachers, and everyone. So that shows that we have now touched 500. So I think from somewhere have joined. As of now, we are 500 in number, which gives me a lot of joy and happiness. So I'm thankful to all of you that you all have just joined this meet, and I'm sure that I will be able to deliver what I intend to deliver through this short webinar. Can I have a just quick check that whether my screen is seen over there? Anyone from the other side?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We can see your screen.
Great. I'm just moving the slides. Just please let me know if the slides are also moving.
Yes, sir. It's moving, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Moving.
Fine. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks for the acknowledgement. Thank you. Without making much ado about the present. Topics, thought of some assessment modules. I thought of some treatment methodologies. Then I realized probably these are all there already in the, I'll just keep my video also stopped for internet instability. So as and when we reach the final round, I'll open my video. I'm just closing it off. Yeah. So then I realized I always feel, I can declare it in the open forum. It is now getting recorded also. I wish to place it in the record. People from Southern India, just because I belong to it, I don't say, but in general also I have seen across the world, I have moved around almost all the states in our country. I was in Punjab for almost 12 years before coming to Gujarat. And when I went for my higher studies and research work and all, it is all everywhere. They say people from Southern India are more sincere, more hardworking, more honest, and they are for the work what they take. So that's how then I realized that this drivers will be one of the most important topic which I can touch, because they are all postgraduates and in the final year and interns, they are in the beginning of their career. So this very sensitive topic, which probably is not regularly covered in our routine syllabus curriculum. And this comes out with a lot of reading materials across the globe, plus with some practical experiences, I have identified few drivers for becoming a best physiotherapy clinician or to have a very good clinical practice. I chose this topic especially for this particular audience. And I address it to my students once in a while, where and when I have a chance during the orientation program or during some evidence-based practice programs or during our exit lectures after the internship. So I take it as a privilege that you two are all my own people. So I wish that I can share something, whatever I have gained in these years of experience learned from my teachers and my students and patients. Let me visit you to my campus in this through this webinar. I'm just sharing a few photographs. This is our campus. We are located in Karamsad, which is the birthplace of Sardar Vallabhai Patel. Everyone know him as Iron Man of India. His house is just opposite to our campus. And we have a 1,000-bedded hospital plus multiple other multi-specialties. We have cancer center, cardiac center. We have almost all the health programs with us. You are all welcome sometime once when the pandemic gets over, as Dr. Sandhil Nathan said, we don't know how tomorrow it is, but sooner with fingers crossed and prayers, I will be happily welcoming you all for some of the other programs which we organize in the coming years. Till then, you can visit virtually through these photographs, which I felt is, it'll be nice for me to show the pictures of my institute. Yeah. Now, moving ahead, I am admitting people who are all coming online. There are some people in the waiting room. So permit me to do that. Yeah.
Recording in progress.
So the context of this topic, we all know that again, Tamil Nadu has put on a lockdown till 7th of June. I read in the newspaper. And this COVID-19 outbreak, which came as a killer disease, as a shocker to our whole globe. I think I should say the whole globe is under maintenance. So it has limited our mobility. In fact, every year, 6 monthly once, I visit my parents who live in Chennai and my sisters who live in Pondicherry. But it's almost been 1.5 years. I could not able to touch Tamil Nadu. I'm just fixed in Gujarat because of this. And it has impacted everyone in the society. And in fact, it has been declared that education is a non-essential service. But but education, though it is non-essential, we, along with other professionals, physiotherapists also has embraced this online platform. And we could able to connect easily, through and through. That's how this webinar is also there. Though you are placed few thousands kilometers away from me, I could able to connect myself with you all. That's how we are with this program. So we as healthcare professionals, we put a lot of efforts to restore the health of the people who need our services. And physiotherapists are an integral part of the whole healthcare system. And you are all aware in the COVID pandemic also, we have done a remarkable job in bringing back the lost functions of these people who are down with COVID. And I recall one Sanskrit saying, which my grandfather taught me when I was a schoolboy, Paropakarartham idam shariram. Many of you must be knowing, being from Tamil background. The Sanskrit verse means that, this body is to serve. There is no regrets for being a physiotherapist, not being a medical MBBS graduate or so. This is one of the best of the professions where you could be able to serve the humanity the best way that you can. And when you have this option, let us use it diligently. Let us give the best to the people who come to our doorstep to get the services for their disability, pain, problems, dysfunctions, and so on and so forth. I pay my sincere thanks at this juncture to all my mentors and teachers who taught me how to be a good clinical teacher and a good clinician. And most importantly, my patients, because of whom I'm a clinician, and my students, because of whom I'm an academician. I pay my regards and respects and thanks to all those who have sculptured me to be a good human being, including my parents. Moving ahead, the objectives are very simple. As I have told you in the beginning, physiotherapy has gained a lot of importance. And I'm sure you people also would have been posted in the COVID-19 COVID wards. Ours is the district hospital in this district of Anand, where our interns, the final years, postgraduates, all are posted across round the clock, 24/7, we give physiotherapy services to the people who are down with COVID. Even we are working in the pre-COVID area who are to prevent certain problems and who are affected during the COVID times and beyond post-COVID also. There are a lot of complications by this time, you all are aware. This is beyond our topic, but still what I mean to say is that it has gained a lot of importance. All the celebrities get into this. So many people are aware about what is physiotherapy, what is its role, and we have walked into all walks of life. As it is rightly said, physiotherapy is from womb to tomb. antenatal care even before the inception of the fetus and till we reach the graveyard, you know, palliative care, hospice care, you know, we are into everything. Every person who is walking on this globe, who is moving around, whom you see, are in need of physiotherapy at one point of time or one time or the other time, either for prevention or for promotion or for curative or for rehabilitation. So that way, we are so closely connected with the human beings, and who else better than us can give the best to the people. You can address to any problems right from top to the toe. The medicine people have limitations to their areas. They can prescribe pharmacology to certain diseases. Surgeons can operate to certain conditions. And dental oral surgeon has got limitation limited to only the oral cavity. But physiotherapist, you can work on migraine problem. You can work on head injury. You can work on Parkinson's disease, fractures, amputation, even to the smallest of Osgood-Slaughter's disease or any even a bunion in your lower toe near the great toe. So name any problems, you have a role to play with. So aren't we so blessed to be into this profession? You know, I just to quote, not to boast more, just as a, you know, to recall, I got my MBBS seat government quota in from Pondicherry. I got my seat in MBBS in Thrissur Medical College. And at the same time, I got physiotherapy government quota in Pondicherry itself. And just because it is in my hometown, I didn't choose physiotherapy. I dropped my MBBS seat and I got into physiotherapy because I was knowing that time what is physiotherapy, what is its impact, and no regrets, and there is no look back into my professional career. The day when I started as a student until today, and I'm sure by the grace of the God in the coming years, till the retirement and post-retirement also, you can be of great use to the humanity. May it be students, being a teacher, may it be a researcher to contribute something to the existing literatures, or as a clinician to the people who comes with all ailments. So you are in the best of the profession. due to the limitations of being in the webinar and online platform, I don't know how far I could be able to interact with you, but I have a few things just to keep you glued with me. Some few questions I'll be putting in front of you. You can use the chat box and we can read through the chat box. You can answer me through the chat box. You can sometime unmute yourself to talk to me also when I say someone can unmute. Right? Until the time you can listen to me. If any question comes, feel free to ask me. If you feel it is very important, right and there you have to stop me there, unmute yourself and tell me, or please note it down at the end of the lecture, probably 5-10 minutes, if at all any questions, I'll be happy to take up. Right, moving ahead. What is the purpose of the lectures? I have already touched it. The healthcare, the world over, is in a massive state of change. We have moved. There are a lot of complexities, caseloads, which is there. You are aware that the best example is COVID-19, and people who don't have any comorbidities, they escape minimal hospital stay. Rather, they are asymptomatic or in home quarantine, they get all right. But those people with other comorbidities such as diabetes or hypertension or thyroid issues, they get into problems. And the present baby boom demographic, it is changing. Every day, the demographic dividend of our country is changing. Thanks to the medical advancements, you have so much investigation procedures, probably some 2 decades before we were not having any such procedures. Because of this advancement, we could able to detect the problem early. We could able to intervene at the shorter time. We could able to prevent the death. Rather, the mortality rate is much more lesser. But at the same time, morbidity is getting increased. And physiotherapists has got an amazing role to supply to that constant demand which is there in the healthcare profession. The trends and drivers which I'm going to mention in this coming next half an hour to 40 minutes will help you to be an efficient healthcare provider, to offer more with less. What I mean to say by more with less is that, you know, to quote an example, when you're going to a shop to buy a dress for your birthday, you know, you don't just look into the price. You first look for example, you know, wherever there is buy one, get one free, buy two, get three free. You know, you try and get that because you want to pay less and get more. That is something which every person, every individual, may it be Ambani's family or a rickshaw puller's family, they try for that. Similarly, we have, as physiotherapists, we have to give the best. We have to give more with less of, you know, energy expenditure, less of intervention. There are many things which have come across the way when I was a student, and now as an academician, clinician, and an administrator, I have seen we have come up a long way. There is a quantum jump in the profession. We have been limited to electromodalities in those years. Now we have so much in our toolkit. It is like a supermarket. Like, you know, when you enter into a supermarket, whether it is Nilgiri's or Spencer's in over there, you see so many things on the in the racks. It is up to us to choose what you want. Similarly, in physiotherapy toolkit, you have so much things now, you know, osteopathy, chiropractors, MET procedures, manual therapy, electromodalities, you know, cupping. So many things are there. So we have to choose the right thing at the right time. When you give the right thing at the right time by the right person, you know, you are going to hit the bullseye. With the less, maybe instead of getting the patient treated for 10 days to give the cure, you could be able to give it in half time. You have to spend only 5 days, thereby you bring the needed recovery in that half time period. That is what is aimed at a physiotherapist as a skillful healthcare provider. So we are going to talk about this. What are those trends? What are those drivers which is there in our profession, which is going to make you the best of physiotherapist? Is it not exciting to know about it? I'm sure those who are in this platform will definitely at the end of the lecture will have some take home message. You know, I'm not going to teach you the skills needed over here. I'm going to teach you the soft skills, which is very much needed to understand the holistic approach of what the profession is all about. Moving ahead. Yeah. Just a sec. I'm moving the slides. I have a question for you. Right. Just a second. Is the slide visible? You can use the chat box to give your answer if you want to. How many of you joined this course by choice? I'm giving some 10 seconds. You can use the chat box. It's a very simple question. How many of you can just put yes, or you can do a thumbs up sign in the chat box to know. How many of you joined this course by choice? Like mine is by choice. The other way is by chance. Some joined by chance. Pushed kar diya. Somebody has pulled me into this course. Okay, I could see many yes. Pani Lavanya, Shatu, Shruti, Vijayalakshmi, Shitosh. Very nice. So if I put the question otherwise, how many of you have joined this course by chance? By choice is Ajil Rajan is by chance. By chance, you can type it by chance. What I mean by chance is, you know, it is difference between arranged marriage and love marriage. If you join by choice, you have a passion for that profession. You got first at love sight and then you got married. And by chances, like arranged marriage, your father found a girl or a boy for you and you didn't have interest. Kadiravan has said it is by chance. Many people have that. So no need to worry about it, whether you have got it married by chance or choice. It is all about not getting divorced. That's more important. There are some Jayabharatis also by chance. Yes. In my class, when I go for the orientation program, if I ask, almost 50% of the people are by chance. Inko MBBS, they didn't get into MBBS. They could not able to get into BDS. Or fees was a problem financially. There is an issue. This was the choice. I got it. Thiruvanangam also has said by chance. Okay. Thanks for your response. That's nice. You got good response. Enough. Thank you so much. So why I'm putting this question is, as I told you, whether it is by chance or by choice. I'm aware that you are all final years and you are all interns and you are all postgraduate students. So now there should be no look back. I don't want the diverse to happen. Like, you know, after there are some people, you know, there is incompatibility between the husband and the wife. Even after the second child, third child is born, people, they separate. You know, that is something which is, I personally feel is a sin. It is unethical, unprofessional. You know, it is 4 years is a good amount of time period. Like, you know, if you remember the Three Idiots movie, you know, you have to do which is very close to your heart. If at all you didn't find it of your choice, 1 year is more than enough for us to quit that profession and get into some other profession. Now that you are into final year and now that you are into postgraduate program, there should be no look back, because by this time you would have seen the nuances of physiotherapy. You would have seen the beauty of physiotherapy, where a surgeon can't do anything. Pharmacology therapy can't do anything. Your physiotherapy is the only stay. I know I always say, is there any medicine? If I ask this question to any one of you, is there any medicine to increase your muscle bulk? You can take protein, you can take that and all, or false pseudo hypertrophies comes. It is only by moving your muscles, then only you could able to build up the muscle. No other medicine can do that. Is there any medicine, jisko koi fracture hua, there is a fracture and there was a joint stiffness. Is there any medicine which can increase the range of motion? No, it is only by mobilizing the joint. It's only through physiotherapy we can do. Like conditions like cerebral palsy, at one point, the initial early intervention, so some extent NICU stay and all are going to help the child to survive. But to make the child functional, to make the child stand, sit, walk, move around, who else other than physiotherapist can do something? Even for that matter, the chronic diseases, age diseases like Parkinson's and all, though levodopa and medicines and all going to keep that on-off period, but who else other than this can increase the coordination of a movement? It is only physiotherapy. So if you look into it, such a beautiful profession we are in, you have a lot of uniqueness. You are unique out of the crowd. You know, nothing comes by chance. Everything, it's all predestined. I strongly believe that even this particular meeting through Dr. Rajalakshmi, that we are connected through this platform, though not seeing each other by face, but we are listening to each other, we are interacting, is also destined. If COVID didn't attack, probably we would not have got connected that easily. Though every year I come to Chennai, I conduct FDB programs to various institutes and colleges and universities across, but there are very less chance that we would have got interacted. So when you strongly see that this is how the destiny plays, and that's how you are all chosen. You are all chosen by the Almighty, that you are all needed for this profession. Every individual who got admission into physiotherapy, who survived this 4.5 years of physiotherapy, who do post-graduation, who get enter into teaching line or clinical line, are all chosen. Please understand that and try to give the best of yours and be unique. Even if you ask who is the number one physiotherapist in our country, the first 100 place is still empty. Agar jiska naam aap le lenge, so for me, he is the number one, number two. No, there is so much vacancy still present in our country that first 100 positions are still vacant. Why not you people fill up that? Because it is just not alone skills. It is beyond that also, which is needed. The affective domain, we call it as in the medical education language, the psychomotor domain, where you try and touch the, you know, individual's softer parts. You have to heal at the soul level. There is joint pain in the knee. An average physiotherapist will just do a mobilization, apply shorter diathermy, glide the joint, stretch the bone and send the patient out. An angelic physiotherapist who is coming as an angel in the life of a person who is suffering from osteoarthritis of knee will go to that level where he eradicate that pain sensation at the brain level also. The pain, the joint has got, you all remember that there is homunculus of brain, you know, the every parts of the body got representation in the brain. The more you use, the size of the homunculus for that particular part increases. For example, an artist, if you do a brain mapping of an artist, his thumb size will be bigger in the homunculus. If you do a brain mapping of a footballer, soccer player, his foot size will be bigger in the homunculus, you know. So that way, the one which is being thought more, the one which is being used more, will be represented more. A person with chronic OA pain, the pain is now just not limited to the osteoarthritic knee joint. It is now represented in the brain. An angelic physiotherapist will work in a such a way that he will treat the person as a whole. I hope you are getting my point. It is not that joint which is getting treated. It is the person who is suffering from osteoarthritis of knee should be treated. We call it as holistic approach. Holistic is just not alone H-O-L-I-S-T-I-C. It is W-H-O-L-I-S-T-I-C, holistic approach as a whole. You have to treat the person as a whole. Okay. So that's what I wanted to say here. Moving ahead. I have one more question. This I want someone to unmute just to check you whether I could able to hear you. One PG, anyone can prepare yourself and one intern can unmute themselves to answer. Before I put the question, can I have one PG who can unmute themselves? Maybe you can keep your video on so that I can see you, that you want to answer this question. It is a very simple question. Who wants to? You can please unmute. You can please open up your camera and say that, sir, I'm there. Who wanted to? One PG, postgraduate student of any specialty.
Any PG can volunteer.
Yeah, anyone, just volunteer, just to interact, just to keep the mood live.
Pavitra, are you online? Pavitralochini.
So that's called as the principal. So he took the name directly. If there is no volunteer, the best part is that the name will be called. So Pavitra is going to be there.
Pavitra is the class coordinator for the PG students.
Okay, so she will take out the name in that case.
Yeah, that's what I called her up.
Oh yeah, great. Anybody, just to interact, you know, it'll be nice to hear some other's voice, not me alone talking. Who wants to? It's a very simple question. Then everybody will unmute if I put the question.
Raji, can you name somebody else?
Vijayalakshmi, Sukla. Sukla is there. Yeah. Vijayalakshmi is there.
Please switch on. Yes, please switch on your camera and unmute yourself. Welcome Ajit to this forum.
Ajit.
Those who speak will be remembered till end.
Ajit.
Ma'am, can I do it?
Kiwi.
Yeah.
Yeah, Kiwi Su. Yeah, good. Very good. Very
thank good. You, Kiwi Su. You are from Northeast?
Yes, sir. I am from Nagaland.
Nagaland. So nice. You understand? You learned Tamil a bit?
Little bit, but I can understand.
Konjam theriyum.
Konjam theriyum.
Very nice. So you did your undergraduation also from the same college?
Yes, sir. Sir, actually I'm UG.
Okay, you are in UG. Great. So which year you are in? Which year?
A final year, sir.
Fantastic. That you set an example. That's leadership. That's boldness. That's courage. You have a way to go. God bless you. The question is very simple over here.
Can we wait for a few minutes? One or 2 minutes so that one or two PGs can join.
Ajit?
Yes, ma'am.
Ajit, yeah. Ajit is there.
Ajit is there. You can switch on your video, Ajit.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you can switch on the video. So meanwhile, I'll put the question to Kiwi, but it is too early for you. I thought of an intern or a PG because the question goes here like this. The question is, the question is, what do you want to become after the course completion? Kiwi, you can answer me. What do you want to become after the course completion? So just speak out your heart.
I don't think this question is new. I think this question has been in my mind since I joined physiotherapy, because right, like you said, it was not by choice that I joined, but it was by chance.
Okay. So
as years are passing by, I want to become a therapist, you know, who treat patients, who will inspire people in our field.
Go ahead.
Because every time I talk to my friends or other people, they think that being a physiotherapist, you know, people actually thought that I'm someone who works in a spa. So there are so many misconceptions, and they don't know about physiotherapy, you know, what is physiotherapy and what we can contribute in this field. So as years are passing by, I want to make some changes, you know, make people aware about what my profession is and let them respect me for who I am.
Okay, you are a passionate physiotherapist, though you got arranged marriage, but you will never get divorced with this profession. God bless you. Thank you. So this lecture is for you. This lecture is absolutely for you. Stay till the end. Thank you, Kiwi.
Thank you, Kiwi Su.
So now I move on to Ajit Kumar. Hi, Ajit. Yes, how are you?
Hi, sir. I'm fine, sir. How are you, sir?
Good, good. Which specialty you are doing in post-graduation?
Neurology, sir. Neurology.
MPT in neurology and psychosomatic disorders, right?
Yes, sir. Combination. Yeah. Yes, sir.
In the second year or first year?
Final year, so second year.
Second year. So you're completing your course. When is your final exams scheduled already?
No, sir. Not yet confirmed, sir.
It will be in the month of September or October.
Oh,
probably.
Right. So just a few months ahead.
If all is well, yeah.
Okay, good. So what is your answer for this question? As a postgraduate, now you are 6 years in this profession, right? Six plus years. So what is your plan?
So actually I'm planning to at the initial stage I'll be planning to work in a multi-specialty hospital sector to gain more experience in treating patients of diverse divisions, and after that I'm planning to move on to any abroad countries to make sure that I'm economically well background. And my main passion is I like to teach a lot, sir. I like to take seminars. I like to participate in a lot of post presentation competitions. So maybe I'll be joining in and universities maybe your university as well, if it's possible, as a professor. And I'll be like, you know, pursuing my, you know, passion of teaching to students and making them to understand what the profession is, how it has to be, like, you know, carried over to next stage, to the next level. And also to, you know, see the patient as a whole, like you said earlier, like to see the patient as a whole, not only to see the site of problem, but also treat the patient mentally in such a way that they are, you know, rehabilitated to the utmost level. So in such a way that I'll be like, you know, taking the I'll be more interested in taking the profession to the next level, sir. So that's
going
to
be my plan. Thank you, Jajit. We need such people. Sky is the limit. Thank you so much. It was nice hearing you as young physios. You are the future generation of our profession, and I'm sure that this drivers will help you to take it. We want people like you, and I think MGR University will be taking pride and be proud of such people who take the institution level as well. As you grow, the institute grows. As you grow, the profession grow. It is give and take. It is mutual. There is no one way. It is back and forth. God bless you. Thank you so
thank
much.
You, thank you. Thank you for the opportunity.
Yeah. Thank you so much. I'll be happy to hear from all of you had it been a offline platform, but due to time limits, I'm just, there are a few more questions which will be coming on the way. That time somebody else can unmute and talk. Moving ahead. I'm moving ahead to the So as listening to Ajit and Kivi, you know, tomorrow some of you in your from your college will become a director of a great rehabilitation center. Some may be managing in broad countries. There are names called as managers, senior physiotherapists, clinic owners, case managers, consultants. There are so many, you know, avenues for a physiotherapist. You can be an employer, you can be an employee, you can be a leader, you can be a team player, you know, you can play across, like how in a cricket line, you know, the one the opener, opening batsman, one down, two down, and till the last batsman. Somebody is using annotation. I request not to write anything on the slides, please. Yeah. So, you know, there is, you can be an opening batsman also, you can be the last batsman, you can be an all-rounder. In fact, that one player is someone is called as an all-rounder who can bowl, who can bat, who can field, who can, you know. So you are one such person that you can be an all-rounder. Sometimes you can be a leading person of the rehabilitation team. You may be the team leader. Sometimes you can be a team player. So that depends on the condition, depends on your role. So you have a lot of scope. That's why I say, as Ajit also pointed out, one needs to be passionate about the profession. One needs to take pride in their profession. One needs to be happy with their teachers. One needs to be happy with the institution, happy with the Almighty, the universe, because it is opening up a lot of arenas for you to, you know, explore more. So you should not have any regrets in your career, because it is up to you. It is all in your hands. In Tamil, there is one saying, un vaalkai un kaiyil. It is all in your hands. You have to take it up to the next level, as he pointed out correctly. Okay. I was talking about the demographic dividend, you know, increasing lifespan and increasing demand. If you closely look into this, you know, from this demographic dividend from 2000 to 2050, you can see, I'm just pointing out the cursor over here, the population aged between for 30 to 60 is going to be much more higher than the population in present scenario. By 2015, you will have more number of people who will be outliving beyond 80 years also. So that means that lifespan, as it got increased, there is increasing demand for physiotherapists, because you know, aging is inevitable, but gracefully aging is in our hands. So that's how these people who are growing older and older day by day can embrace preventive physiotherapy by getting on supervised care, or those who get into problem, physiotherapy plays a major role. So this demographic dividend is in favor of us. You know, so what are the drivers which I'm talking about? Drivers are the indicators of this talk is not intended to predict the future of physiotherapy. I'm not here to predict the future of physiotherapy as a profession, but it is here to inform you. It is here to educate you and to provoke you to consider these trends which can affect your practice today, tomorrow, and in future. So these are all certain, I have just zeroed down certain Just a second. Yes, Rajeshwari, Sunil. So these are all going to help you to understand how it is going to affect your practice. There are a lot of drivers, there are a lot of trends, but to limit to the talk for less than 1 hour, I have taken out the most important 5 drivers and one more additional thing which can help you to understand why this physiotherapy is really going to help you in your practice. Let me go on to the drivers one by one. Now I'll be directly coming on to the topic. One, the first driver is the patient, the shift. You know, we are the driver one is the patient. Who calls you as a doctor? Who calls you as a physiotherapist? It is the patient who calls you as the therapist. Who can I request people to keep themselves muted? Yeah. So the shift is from system focused to patient centered. Like how in the education scenario, when we were students, it was all curriculum driven. It was all teacher centric. Whatever the teacher talks, the student listens. And now the revision has come up in such a way that the curriculum is designed keeping the student center, that is student centric teaching, student centric learning. Similarly, in the medical model also, now it was initially it was physician driven. Whatever the doctor says, you have to take it. You know, if you ask your today, you go back home and talk to your daddy, your mother, you ask, whom do you approach whenever you had a problem? They used to have a person called as family doctor, whether it is diarrhea, whether it is fracture, whether it is headache. He is the person who gives any medicine, and without even asking any question, your daddy or your mommy swallow the tablet and get all right. There was no involvement of the patient. Patient becomes passive. But now, you know, it is all patient centric. And you will all agree with me. When I was a student, the patient used to come with back pain. That's it. Back pain. So you have to identify which back pain, whether it is upper, middle, lower back. But nowadays, the patient who comes to our department, you know, they come and talk to me. And, you know, it is a fact, probably many of you must be experiencing it. They come and tell you that, sir, I have L5, S1 disc prolapse indenting the thecal sac also. This much amount of, details the patient gives you that you become fabulous. You know, it is something, you know, you get overwhelmed. You get, you know, what is that fabulous? What is that the patient is talking about? He knows everything. Patient-centric. That is what is. So your treatment plan should be patient-centric. In that, I have few points to talk about. What do you understand by the term SDM? Can I please request people not to write on the slides? It doesn't give a good clarity for me to look into the slides, please. Please don't write anything. You can write in the chat box if you want to write something.
But now it's don't scribble anything on the screen.
Yeah, there is no clarity for me to
kindly keep what watching.
Yeah. So without taking time, those who wanted to listen, what do you understand by the term SDM? Don't say divisional magistrate. It is related to medical science. Anyone knows? Very few must be knowing the abbreviation. I'm sure you may not be able to, but if someone wants to write, you can put it in the chat box. What is SDM according to you? I'll just give 10 seconds for people to respond. If somebody wants to try, the hint is it is not beyond medicine. It is within medicine. Anybody wants to?
Okay. Solven. I think it is Solven who is drawing. If you want, you can leave the meeting. Don't disturb the session.
Thank you for helping me. So please, those who doesn't want to listen, you feel free to move out of the webinar. Perfectly all right. It is for those who are here only to learn those drivers, those who want to be the pioneers, those who want to be the change makers, those who want to be the best in the profession. Rest all can slowly leave without even intimating. Yeah. So the SDM means shared decision making. Okay. SDM means shared decision making. Yeah. Someone has written it so beautifully. SK Meenakshi. Many people have written it. Thank you so much that you all know. So can I ask anyone of you, Ahalya, Meenakshi, or Dharini to unmute and talk about it rather than me speaking again and again? Someone, anyone of you, those who have written that shared decision making. Santoshni. Anyone, please unmute yourself and say whatever you have an idea. Can I ask Santoshni? I think she was the one first to write that expansion, shared decision-making. Can I have Santoshni on the mic?
Hello, sir.
Yes, please. Thank you, Santoshni, for rightly taking out. You are a PG student?
Hello, sir. Is my voice audible?
Perfectly audible. Please go ahead. Yeah. I can hear you. You can speak. What is share? You are muted. Please unmute yourself.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Yes, Santoshni, you can unmute yourself and you can speak. I could able to hear you. Hello, are you there? I think we have lost Santoshni. Can Yuvraj come on the stage? Yuvraj Kumar. You can say something. Are you there, Yuvraj?
Yuvraj?
You are there. Okay, no problem. Since there is a lack of time, let me just quickly go on to it. No problem. Sometime later, we can discuss more about it. It is, the word itself is self-explanatory. Shared decision making is where the decision making power is not limited to the physician or the physiotherapist or anyone who handles. It is where the patient is also involved. The photograph which I'm going to show you in the next slide will give you the thing. Here you can see the patient health is kept in between. Patient health and patient is also part of the discussion team. Initially, the previous decade, it is all the people who treat, maybe the nurse or the doctor or the physiotherapist or the surgeon. I know they all communicate to the patient. Patient is on the other side of the table. But if you see now in this slide, if you could able to see it clearly, patient is part of the discussing team. He will be, that's how this informed consent are all there. We ask them that TKR is to be done, means it's not the doctor who decides. It is always said that it is not the doctor who need to sell the therapy. It is the patient who need to buy it, that I want this. Can you please go ahead with this? So there is always a mutual interaction which happens and the patient health is kept in the center. What is good for him, her? There are a lot of factors which influences the decision-making. It is just not alone the health factor, the financial factor, his family background, environmental background, multiple factors are all there, which probably only when you allow the patient to speak out, you will be able to take the best of your therapy. Right? There is a cultural shift in the healthcare where we involve the patients, of course, and their families also to be part of the conversation. That's what is all about, shared decision-making. So there is a shift from, you know, from physician-centric to the patient-centric. Second, the driver two is from sick care to healthcare. You know, the whatever the hospitals, if you see around you, whether it is Tamil Nadu or Odisha or Punjab or Gujarat, you know, majority of the hospitals in our country, they don't run as a healthcare sector. They are all more as a sickness industry. Means everybody, every hospital is, you know, is having hungry for the patients. They want the patient to come, get the treatment done, make money about it. So any intensive care today in any hospital becomes an expensive care. The patient has to sell their land, sell their houses when they got admitted into the hospital for some of the other problems. Now the focus has got shifted from sickness to healthcare, which means the focus is more on wellness. It is more on prevention. It is more on health promotion. So that is how we are now moving on. If you see, as I told, you know, that the people with disability, you know, it is in 2011, if you just calculate by 2036, it is doubled up. And in 2051, if you see the person with disability, you will be having one among the four will have some or other disability. So in that case, how disability occurs, there is lack of early diagnosis. There is lack of money which is spent on prevention. You know, we spend lakhs and lakhs of money on treatment, but we need to spend money on health promotion and prevention of disease. As you all know that WHO also defines what is a health. It is just not mere absence of disease. It is, you know, sense of well-being. So evidence-based physiotherapy is very much essential and early diagnosis is better for patients and makes good economic sense because we are going to face 1 in 4 among the people in 2051 will be having some other disability. And therefore, we have to promote fitness. We have to promote prevention and we have to go for health promotion. In our school days, you all remember, we used to study something called as prevention is better than cure. But now we have to remove that better word also. Prevention is cure. Okay. And the third driver is moving from silos to networks. It is about all about the practice. We are still talking about the practice. What do you mean by silos? silos is something, a word which depicts a uniprofessional practice. That is, I am working in silos. There are some people who don't believe in others. There are some physiotherapists, there are some orthopedic surgeons, there are some physicians, neurologists who feel that I am the only one who can do the best for this patient. If I refer the patient to the next disciplinary profession, probably my patient will be lost. I will not be able to track them. So those people are working from silos. That means that only uniprofessional identity, but we need to now move to networking. The shift should be from single profession to multi-professional, interprofessional practice, we call it as. That itself is a different practice. Collaborative care is a different practice. But this photograph gives you a clear picture. You know, here it is uniprofessional. The doctor works, the physiotherapist works separately, the surgeon works separately. There is no communication which happens between these professionals. But whereas here, if you see in this profession, there is an absolute communication between that. An orthopedic surgeon operates, a physiotherapist treats, and then he sends back the patient to the orthopedician to check for the recovery. And again, the orthopedician refers him back to the physiotherapist to go for much more functional mobility. So there is always a constant communication which happens. That is called as collaboration. In collaboration, there is no I. It is all we. We all come together. It is we who make the person independent. It is we who make the person much more functional. There is nothing. The driver, I still myself feel I'm not that tech savvy. I feel I'm electronically handicapped, but still we have to embrace the technology. This is technology driven society. We have to move from disconnected to connected. What is that? I'll show you the technology triage. We have nowadays patients are not only patients, they are e-patients. E-patients is and they are empowered patients and they are to be engaged patients. So we are in the 21st century and technology is in the fingertip. That's how this Zoom platform, if it is not there, they may not be connected. And now telemedicine is in practice. Telephysiotherapy is in practice. You can just give your services sitting here in Tamil Nadu. You can address a patient who is in Detroit. You can be able to communicate with them so easily. You can send all those HEPs, that is that home exercise protocols. All these things can also be sent through the apps. There are a lot of applications where you can able to supervise the exercise program. You could able to prescribe, you could able to check the adherence, you could able to give them the feedback and could able to progress, grade the exercises through the applications. The mobile apps are much more friendly. So we have to make use of those available resources. A person who don't embrace technology today becomes evicted. He may not be in the society at all. Completely one generation down. And I think we need to take pride in this. All our students are much more technologically stronger than us. I personally feel as faculty, as teachers, you know, they are all much more tech savvy and they know how to operate. My sons are better than me. They teach me certain things, how to open up an app, how to use this application, this and that. My sons are better than me. So that's how I think you can all be a better physiotherapist than us. At this age of 45, 50, it is a little bit tougher to have the mental flexibility to learn new things, but still, The research says that the aging brain, the flexibility doesn't go even up to the age of 80 years. Though the brain shrinks, but learning is a never-ending process. And you are all in the beginning of your career. You people can fantastically learn those technology and can use it to the maximum and be the best physios who practice physiotherapy in the field. And I'm admitting few people, bear with me. Yeah. So next, moving ahead, this is how. You know, the primary care physician, if you have the application, you know, you can share this with all the files can be given, transferred to the physiotherapist and again back to the physician patient. So there is a constant communication, transfer of information between the treating physiotherapist and the patients using various folders, applications, mobile, even this, you know, Fitbits, the watches are also now enabling all these, you know, medical all these applications can be operated through the Fitbits also. You can use all those functions. And the next driver is the system. We are in almost the fag end of our topic. I have only two, three more slides to go. Fragmented to integrated, the system. Because whatever said and done, today I'm talking to you all these things. Until unless MGR University opens up an arena to collaborate, you know, it has to come from the managerial level. It has to come from the provost, vice chancellor, or the hospital administrator. You know, everywhere the change should occur. But we need to be the change maker. We need to be the change agents. We need to be the person who share all this information. When you are equipped, when you are empowered, people will listen to you. When you go with evidences, you can able to do it. So integrated practice are much more beneficial to bring global healthcare to the bigger level than the fragmented healthcare. Fragmented is what I was talking about. So in that, you know, we can move from volume to value. It is not the quantity which matters. It is the quality which matters. You know, if per capita money which is spent on one single person is much more higher than the amount which is spent for epidemic, pandemic. You know, when you take care of the global health, the individual health is taken care of. So the value for money is when you work on the quality. So, and finally, the most important driver for a successful career. I have talked about five drivers moving from patient to system. Though there are many more drivers, but I'm going to point out a most important driver, which is very, very essential. This is the last segment of our talk. I may be finishing off this session in another 5 to 10 minutes maximum. Can anyone would like to guess, which is there in your mind, what could be the another important driver, which you think, which is essential to be a successful best physiotherapy clinician? Can someone write in the chat box or unmute and talk about it? It includes teachers also, faculty too can interact. Any drivers which comes in your mind after listening to me, the five important drivers? I'll wait for a few seconds. Okay, passion. Kivi has written passion, Santosh in dedication. Okay, good. Anything else? Please go ahead with your vocabulary. Passion, dedication. Then, please go ahead. Skills. Okay, Ashwini Rani has written skills. Networking. Network is the network problem or the network? I don't know. Somebody has written network issue. Somebody has written network. Network anyway, if it is a driver, we have already talked about. Silos to network. Desire to develop. Interest. Individual. Perseverance. More knowledge. Beautiful. Then I'm waiting till I drink water, a glass of water. Who teaching about this field? Confidential, like teacher, creating trust. Beautiful. Okay. Thank you. You can keep writing in the chat box. No limits. You give your ideas. It will be nice. You know, we learn from each other. I always believe it is not a one-side teaching. Not want to be a can be a physiotherapy. Oh yeah, I got the answer from Ashwini Rani Pandey. If I am there offline, I will stand up and give a applause to you. You got the right answer. Ashwini, can I please have yourself video on to see?
Yes, sir.
Where are you? Let me just open up and see. Yes, Ashwini, you have touched the core of physiotherapy. Not alone physiotherapy, Ashwini. You have touched the core of any professional. Maybe a chef in a hotel, or a surgeon in a surgery department, or a physiotherapist. You have touched the most important aspect called as professionalism. Congratulations to you. You got the right answer. Though all other answers are also very, very right. Skills are important. Everything is important. But professionalism is the most important driver, which I'm talking about. I have written the answer, what you have written it.
Thank you, sir.
Professionalism. So, can you say what, according to your understanding?
Sorry, sir?
Can you say a few words about professionalism? What do you mean by that?
Yes, sir. In this context, professionalism means we have to be fully dedicated, and we should we should enjoy what we are doing in a very professional manner. Like, if we are treating a patient, we should give full focus to that patient. We should not divert our mind in different things.
Right. Good. So thank you for bringing this important point at the end of this lecture. In fact, I kept this deliberately at the end of the lecture, because it is only for those who are going to stay with me till the end. I'm going to give you a nice story. This is very close to my heart. I'm to explain professionalism rather than using those tough terminologies with different medical jargons or English jargons. I am going to narrate a story. You can keep yourself muted, video off, Ashwini, if you want to, or else you can be the way you want to. I'm going to share a story. So I'm keeping my camera on because this is an important thing. This is very close to my heart. This story gives you the crux or the essence of what professionalism is. When you understand this story, I have shared this story in multiple platforms. I have used in my personal blogs also. I talk to all the students. Wherever there is a possibility where I can touch professionalism, I share this story. And that's how in this webinar also, I'm sharing this story, which is not alone a story. It is a real life happening. It is a real thing which has happened in a small hamlet in the state of Karnataka, in near Mysore district. There is a small town over there. This real thing happened, which I'm going to share it over here as a story. And when you listen to this story, you will understand what is professionalism. And I'm sure all those who are in this platform as of now will keep this story in their mind till their professional practice and share it with as many people as you can, so that we can bring our profession to the heights. There are 439 people. I wish that they stay back till the story is over. Right. The story goes like this. This is all about a person whose name is called as Mahadev. The hero of the story is Mahadev. I'll take a couple of minutes to share the story. It is a nice story, but I'll try to concise it in 2-3 minutes to make you understand what is professionalism. This story, this happened some 30 years before. This happened in 30 years before when this Mahadev, now he is around 50, 55 years. He is still alive. He is still there in that particular hamlet near Mysore district in Karnataka. When this story happened, it was 30 years before when he was a small boy. He was survived with his mother, no father. He passed away when he was a small child. And this mother also belongs to a very, very low economic strata. She used to go to houses over there to clean the utensils, to clean the houses, daily wages. She used to do all those small petty jobs of that house and earn money out of it and feed this boy. So this boy had never entered any school. He used to just go around. He used to go around the place and play with in the sand, do some petty task, and was leading his life. Years went on. The boy grew. He became a teenager. The mother became older. And one fine morning, the mother fell sick. So the villagers took the mother to the nearby primary healthcare center, which is a very, very small hospital with basic facilities. She was investigated over there. The boy also went to the hospital because what he will do in the village when the mother is not there. So mother was diagnosed with some severe life-threatening disease, and she was hospitalized over there. And this boy stayed in the hospital only in the corridor. He used to play there in the corridor, and those relatives of the patients who were all there, he used to talk to them, and he used to buy certain small things, whatever is needed for those people, and got some money for getting medicines for her mother like that. And one fine morning, the mother also, after a few weeks, she also passed away. So this teenager boy, Mahadev, became an orphan. He had nobody else in his family. And the villagers felt very bad for this boy. They took curtsy. And what they did was they talked to this teenager boy, Mahadev. They told him, Mahadev, why don't you come back to the village? Now no one is there. Your mother is also not there. He was buried in that nearby graveyard in the hospital. Incidentally, there was a graveyard near the hospital. And an old man used to burn or bury, as per the rituals, all those bodies. Where those people who die in the hospital, there are no one unclaimed bodies, accident bodies who come from different places. This old man used to do all those things ritualistically in that graveyard. So his mother was also buried and burned over there in that place. And this boy saw all these things. And when the villagers called him, can we go back to the village? You do some small petty jobs for us, and we will pay you something. We will give you some food to eat. You can survive over there, thinking that they can help this boy. But, you know, to the surprise of everybody, this boy said, he denied that, I don't want to come to the village. My life is going to be in this graveyard. I'm going to live with this old man who is doing all these, burying job and, burning job of the dead bodies. I'm going to be with this old man, assisting him in this. So he voluntarily took up this job of burning the dead bodies, unclaimed bodies, or burying the unclaimed bodies, whichever comes to that graveyard. People were surprised, shocked, and said, what is this task you are taking, Mahadev? dead body, why are you working? Why are you going to do with this dead bodies? Come back to the village, do some disciplined job, do some respectable job. You can help us in our daily course. And we will pay you something, we will feed you. But this boy right away denied, no, I'm going to be with this old man only. So after great pursuance, they failed and all the people went back to the village. And this boy stayed in that graveyard. He used to see the old man doing all the tasks, everything, and he took over all the work. And at one point of time, this old man, after he passed away, this Mahadev took over the task of taking up. And to the surprise of everybody, this boy started liking the task so much, like how Ashwini pointed out, doing with passion. Burying or burning the bodies become his passion. Whatever the unclaimed bodies come over there, accident, all these disfigured faces. Sometimes the body comes after 3-4 days also, a lot of pus in the body. This boy used to clean the body diligently and garland the body. And agarbati, he used to burn the agarbati, create some nice incense smells over there, do aarti for that, pray to the Almighty. And then he used to bury or burn the body. This message spread across Karnataka, that there is one man called as Mahadev who takes away all these unclaimed bodies, not related to him, but he does everything in a diligent way with prayers, garlanding and incense sticks. And then he see off that body, whether it is to be burnt or buried. The news spread like fire. People come from across the place to see him, who is Mahadev, what he does. And, you know, people assisted him with vehicle to bring the body. Police official used to call Mahadev wherever the unclaimed bodies are all there. He used to be called. And to share the information, you all must be aware, Rajiv Gandhi assassination, those people who have been hanged. And he was the one who burnt the body of that terrorist also. Mahadev was the one who received the body of those terrorists who killed Rajiv Gandhi, the then prime minister. His name became so famous. And one day, the governor of Karnataka in early 90s, and the mid of 90s, I suppose, there is the story, it is all published in Hindu. I know, and this story came as a publication. And he was honored, called to the stage, and the governor of Karnataka, gave him, a shawl and honored him with a medal to say that he is such a dedicated professional who is passionate about his task and took his profession as his, prayer. And he was praised for that, and his work was published in the Hindu newspaper in that days. And his son is now there. He got his son studied engineering and all, but still he is continued doing this. Even now this task is going on. He is now almost 50, 55, 60 years. And his son is also assisting in all these rituals of burning and burying the bodies, in spite of he has studied engineering also. So the story, the lesson learned out of the story is that he chose his profession on his own. It was not trusted to him. That means that he has taken his profession by choice. And then he was not having any boss over. If you recall all the students, if the teacher is there, they become quiet. If the teacher is there, they don't copy the paper. When the teachers move out of the classroom, they try to copy or they chat. It is all, we want to be supervised. But this boy, he was not reporting to anybody. There was no performance appraisal for him. There was no increment given to him. Salary was not paid by any people. Whatever the amount the people give at the end of it, he used to take it. He didn't work for money. He didn't work for performance appraisal. He didn't work for anybody's satisfaction. By anybody, he worked on his own diligently to the maximum. And the third most important point of professionalism is he compared himself for the growth. He was not told to improve his task. This old man who was doing that burying task didn't tell him to do garlanding, didn't tell him to blow the incense sticks or do prayers. He excelled his task comparing himself. He was not comparing with anybody else. He was comparing within himself. I was yesterday like this. Today, I need to do better. Tomorrow, I will do much more better. So that is the third point of professionalism. This Mahadev exhibited, though a non-school goer, he didn't go to any college. He was not taught anyone. He was not taught by anyone about professionalism, but he truly exhibited professionalism by choosing his own task on his own, without supervision, doing the work passionately, with full passion and diligently, and then improvising, excelling in his work. These are the three main points. in a book called as Professionalism by Subrato. He has quoted this Mahadev story also as part of his professionalism. That's how I'm sharing this. It is not taken from elsewhere. It is published article. So if you understand this one man, Mahadev, who was working with the dead bodies can exhibit professionalism, we as highly qualified physiotherapists with specialty with us, how nicely we should exhibit professionalism. This is one of the most important driver, which is number one, but I purposely put it at the end because I can end this talk with a story which can give you a long lasting impact, and I'm sure that you will take up in your life and exhibit true professionalism in your life. So the things to remember is the take home messages. Please look at the person as a whole. Don't treat only the joint or the disease. Equip, educate, engage, enable, and empower the person who comes to you. May it be the patient or the patient relatives. Educate them. Next is develop interprofessional team. Go from silos to networking. Collaborate with people and involve the patient in important decision-making process, which is SDM. Then go extra miles to bring smile. You know, I was given a task of 1 hour only to talk. I have taken a little bit extra mile so that I can bring smile in your face. If out of this 500 people, even if 5 people take up the message, my purpose of talking in this webinar has been achieved. Go extra miles, talk to the patient, spend time. The best thing that you can give to the patient is not money, food or anything. It is the time. Talk to them, be with them. And the last point is practice wellness. Go for predictive practice, preventive practice and promotive practice. Don't wait for the disease to set in. Don't wait for the curative thing to happen or the rehabilitative plan to happen. Practice wellness. That's how even this present government also has started with Ayushman Bharat, wellness clinic, adolescent health clinic. These are all promotive health. Though it is now coming from Western culture, but this has been practiced by our age-old saints, Siddhas. Our Southern India is a heritage for that. All these things are all, whatever in written in the Ayurveda over there are all about wellness and prevention. Practice that. These are the take-home messages. And I think whatever that I wish to convey through this webinar, in the short time with the crux of it, I have conveyed it. And thanks a ton to each one of you. Special thanks to Dr. Rajalakshmi and her team. And thanks to Dr. Selvanathan, the principal of the institute, and all the students who have assembled in this forum to listen to my talk. And I have shared my email ID and numbers, which is having WhatsApp also. You can have any questions, you can ask me, any literatures you want related to the drivers, I can share it with you. And if time permits, I can take up one or two questions. Otherwise, you can write to me anytime. Let's all be a humble and a highly responsible healthcare provider. First as a good human, then as a healthcare provider, then the physiotherapist. God bless everyone. Thank you so much. Over to the organizers. I'm done with the talk. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for the wonderful presentation. And I'm a little bit extremely sorry for the lot of things that's happened in between. Some people have
That's absolutely all right. Screen. Students and, are students. My student does that. Yeah. So no mind. No, never mind. No problem.
From my side, I want to apologize for that. And we have been taking out those miscreants from this session. That's what we are doing at the backstage. And sorry Thank for you. That. But anyway, it's a absolutely. Wonderful session. And you have showed a new path for the profession of physiotherapy and for the budding physiotherapists from our university, and new perspective, I would say a new perspective from the lateral thinking, what has been, what people have think in their mind in a normal pattern. So a little bit deviate from that normal pattern and in depth what we have to do as a profession, and more than that as a human being to the patient. Yes, thank you. Wonderful. It was a wonderful
medical
session.
Education. Yes, in sir. Medical education, as a famous fellow, we talk about something called as hidden curriculum. This is hidden curriculum probably because this is not explicit in our routine curriculum. So these are all implicit. So which we need to do it. That's how I thought that I can take out this hidden curriculum to the budding physios, as you correctly said. Since Dr. Rajalakshmi told me it is all final years and interns and PGs, I thought this will be good for them.
Yes.
There was one hand raise.
Thank you. Thank you for that. I think our association will not end today. It will continue different angles. Let us have some mutual understanding between our two universities and in knowledge sharing, research work, jointly done research work. And we have a lot of things in our institution for research purpose. And for information, we have published a lot of papers in Scopus journals, and to our credit, we have almost 2 patents.
Very good.
Earlier I said the strength of the institution lies not in the infrastructure, rather it lies in the human resources. So we Absolutely. Have a very good human resource in the form of faculties as well as students. With their support and keeping them in my mind, and we are progressing a lot, both academic as well as in the extracurricular things. And thank
very
you,
glad.
Thank you very much for your wonderful session. I hope you remember me because in 2000, I suppose in your first batch of SRM PG, I was there as a staff member there in UG.
Right.
I belong to the first batch of BPD in SRM, 93 batch.
Oh, Acha, when I joined as a MPT, you were there as a faculty.
Yeah, I was there. Yes. I left Very good. In the year 2002 only.
Okay, beautiful. So we know we are connected long before.
That's what it's destiny. Yeah. As you said in the earlier, we are destined to meet today.
Yes, we are re-establishing that.
19 years.
Absolutely. I'm very happy. And as you said correctly, this is one beginning to connect ourselves for professional and personal growth. Yes. And thanks to Dr. Rajalakshmi to form the bridge between you and me as such. And I heard a lot about it.
Without her, we would not have been in touch today.
Now, the moment you said, I recall, I'm so happy that I could able to establish the connection with you and with your institute. And thank you so much
Thank you. Over to Deepthi.
Thank you so much, sir. That was a very informative and a very interactive session. And thank you for the story, especially. So any questions?
Yeah, one or two. I'm very happy to share if anything has anybody wants to.
If anybody wants to ask some questions to sir, you're open now. You can ask.
Not alone questions. If they want to add something, because on the other side, I wish to learn. There are these people have some good things also. I'll be happy to hear from them too.
Yes, staffs and the students. If you want to ask anything to sir, you can ask now.
I'm looking at the chat box. If any question comes, it's all only thanks message. So thank you so much for your overwhelming response, and I'm glad to see.
Okay. Chat box only thank you messages are pouring.
Thank you messages.
That's what I. If anybody have written any question, I thought I can answer.
I think it's a
thought provoking thing. There may not be any much of. It is all about thinking, and we have to do reflection about what has been told in this. And I'm sure they all will be a great professional, more than us as teachers. I wish them all the best. And may the Almighty shower the blessings to all the budding physios to be the best in the society.
Thank you for your blessings, sir.
Thank you, sir. So we would like to showcase a small video clipping on our university's pride.
Let's have the
clipping now.
Thank you. Wish to. Yes.
Video. I'll stop sharing. Yeah.
Okay. I have to do stop sharing. I'm doing that so that you could be able to do that, right?
Yes, sir.
Now I've done it.
This video was created by our students.
Acha, okay, nice.
It will project what we were almost 10 years back and what we are today.
Very nice.
After a decade. So it will project.
I wish I see the university and you all when I come to Chennai once in the pandemic gets over.
We are waiting to have you in person in our place. Thank you.
I'll be happy. Thank you. Look forward to.
Is the screen visible, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, Your Honor.
I can see.
Your Honor, the audio is not there.
Yeah, audio is not there.
Your Honor, audio is not there, ma.
Sir, audio full irukku, sir.
They are the first batch of MPT students. What do you see there?
Oh, okay.
Rajalakshmi is there.
She's there, yes. But the photos are quite fast. I'll be happy to, if you can share it through WhatsApp also, I can. Dr. Hari Om is there.
Yeah. He was our first batch student in MPT. Okay. Actually, in the year 1998, we have started the UG program here under Tamil Nadu MGR Medical University.
Right.
So from there, 98 to 2003, we have been admitting students from MGI Medical University through counseling, all those things. From there, 2003, we have attained the status of deemed university.
Okay.
So we had at the time dental college, engineering college, architecture. From the medical side, we had only physiotherapy, not even MBBS, even nursing or pharmacy was there.
Right. From
medical
side,
we are the only college, physiotherapy, in the year 2003. We became deemed university. And by the year 2005, they have started nursing college, BSc nursing. And then by 2008, we have started the medical college under ACS Medical College banner.
ACS.
ACS Medical College. That's the name of our founder chancellor, through ACS. And what you're looking now is our campus, ACS Medical College campus here in Velappan Javadi, next to Savita College.
Right.
So here in this campus, almost we have five faculties. We have physiotherapy, we have MBBS, we have pharmacy, we have nursing. And 2 years back, we have started Allied Health Sciences program also.
Achha.
So almost five faculties are put together in this campus, Velappan Javadi campus. So what we are looking at the screen is our campus now.
Beautiful. Huge.
Yeah.
And with greenery around. That's the most important. I see the greenery around, which is very essential.
Yeah. So this is one of our classroom. So we have all the classrooms as Wi-Fi enabled.
Wi-Fi enabled.
Smart room.
ICT.
ICT, yeah. We have, this is our library. What you see now is library. It's a fully automated library.
Right.
So
open access.
We have all the codes. We have given the ID cards with the scanner codings, all those things. And all the books have been with what you call as the barcoding system. So we follow the barcoding system. So students can just come in and show the ID card there in the scanner. And taking any books, go to the librarian and scan the book and scan the card. It will automatically be stored in the system. Which book has been taken by which student?
Very useful. It becomes easier for the student to access.
It's easier. And we have an exclusive internet section. So the net speed is a bit slow, I suppose, because all these things is in video mode. But what you're seeing now in still small.
Still mode. Yeah. But I think it's a blessing in disguise. I could able to get the running commentary, so it becomes much more easier for me to understand.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
It's nice to, I could able to pace up with the things as you coordinate.
This is our internet section.
Electrotherapy.
What you see is our electrotherapy lab. Almost we have three electrotherapy labs and equipments.
For teaching purpose. This is for teaching purpose.
Teaching as well as practical purpose. This is not connected with the
clinic,
outpatient department. No, that is different. So this is only for the students' practice purpose.
Learn, yes.
So this is our exercise therapy lab. So this is routine.
Quite spacious.
Yes. Almost we have four exercise therapy labs. What you see is just one of them. So each lab will have all these kind of materials like Guthrie Smith apparatus, like all your, this is one of the research labs.
Very nice.
This is laser. Our multi-purpose laser.
Laser.
And he's Dr. G.P. Paul, our research supervisor.
Oh.
So under him, almost 9 scholars are there doing their PhDs now.
Right. OPD.
This is our OPD. This is our OPD, and he's Dr. Satyaraj, OPD in charge.
Almost a virtual tour, I'm getting it. Very nice. I get the feel of it. Whosoever the student has made it has covered almost all the things without visiting physically. I could able to see
this video has been done by our students only.
That's what my special appreciation to the person who had done it. Really nice.
No, there was a very nice background score also there, but unfortunately, we were not able to hear that.
I can get it shared through WhatsApp sometime.
Yeah, sure. We'll share it. We'll share with you.
It's very nice to see. I'm very happy
one of
that
the conference you have conducted in 2017.
17.
For
that
17. Our principal of Government College of Physiotherapy, Dr. Srinivasan, was a chief guest for that conference. And apart from the this is our Pungal Vira.
Pungal.
Here we celebrate in a very grand manner.
Culture. That's very essential.
These are our staff members. Female as well as a male. And he's our respected secretary, sir. He's our medical director. We observe all kind of religious festivals like Pongal, as I said, and for this thing, Christianity, for we'll observe
all religion.
Religion, yes. Ramzan, we observe. We host iftar party also.
Acha, beautiful. You have got a spacious, huge acres of land. Yes, I guess
you have a very, very big playground. You know, these are all the our team, separate teams, our college team.
We must be having inter-college competitions also regularly.
Intra-university, we are the overall champion in our university, Dr. MGR University. And last year, we got the overall championship in SRM University.
Achha,
inter-university sports meet.
Inter-university.
Yes. Luckily, our university encourages a lot of extracurricular activities.
Overall, growth of the person depends on the physical activity too. Yes, it is very essential.
Exactly. I do agree.
Beautiful. I feel happy that, you know.
Thank you, sir. Thank
Subhash
you.
Khatri. Subhash Khatri is
Subhash
there.
Khatri, yeah, came down. Yeah, yes, come down here twice. And Uma Shankar Mohanty also has come down. Uma Shankar Mohanty also has come down.
Yeah. Subhash Khatri is a very good friend of mine.
He is in Gujarat now, no? I suppose.
No, he moved to Gujarat. Otherwise, I used to go to Pravara regularly for PhD committee.
Okay. And a lot of our staff members, this is one of the patents, what you see.
Patent, right.
So, Rajalakshmi has one patent in the credit. And she along with the students has done this one.
She's very dynamic. Foot dynamometer, okay.
And got the patent. And one of our staff members, Dr. Bernard, along with his team members, he also got one patent in wheelchair.
Such things only can bring the profession up. Yes. Very good.
And recently, we have got last year, two projects, funded projects.
Each
2.5 lakhs each. And this year, we have got approval for 6 projects, funded projects.
Very good. Very good. Very good. I really appreciate and I take pride. It is my own hometown people. Very nice.
Thank you, sir. He's our founder chancellor, Dr. A.C. Shanmugam, sir. He's a man.
My respects and regards to him.
Yes.
My respects and regards to him.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. And he is his son, Engineer A.C. Arun Kumar, sir. And he's our current president. He is managing the university now.
University now. Very good. Nice. So such dynamic people who are open for suggestions, if they are there, the university will definitely grow.
Definitely. We can go to see, whatever height
we
want, we can achieve it. Yeah.
You have a very good team that way. That's what I said in the beginning. I said 400-500 people enrolling and being there in the webinar is a big success. Yes. Otherwise, people, they say in thousands, but not less than, I know, you won't get beyond 100 also people who sit and listen. So that's a big
success.
Our
secretary, he is in charge of our campus, what we are here today in Velappan Javadi.
Acha.
Three Ravi Kumar.
Yeah.
No, without these, our management support, we would not have been able to achieve all these things, what we are today now.
Very nice. Beautiful. I'm very happy to, from here itself, I could able to see everybody. So I'm now familiar with your institute now, and I happen to see.
And I want to make it in record, like all these things would not have happened without the support of my faculty members.
Absolutely.
So they are the pillars of this, our college. Without them, what you have seen today in this video would not have been there. Would have been in paper
I,
only.
I congratulate from my side for all the teamwork. And
in this forum, I would like to thank all my staff members who have been there and who will be there in future also for what we are today. Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
This is a brief video about our institution, sir.
I'm very happy and you took time to share this and I'm glad that I could able to witness all these things. Thank you so much for your running commentary as well, which makes me understand.
Thank
everything.
You, sir. Thank I you. Hope I haven't bored you with this video.
No, not at all. Rather, it is, in fact, I am a specialist in neurobics.
Okay.
You know, these are all certain things which can make your brain much more functional and active. I enjoyed it thoroughly. Rather, that shows how much amount of commitment, dedication you people are having it. It is, as you said correctly, it is the people who make the university. The passion that you have for that, I could able to feel for it. Thank you so much for taking out time to share this.
Thank you, sir. Meeting. Thank you for your patient listening and watching all these things. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Over to Deepthi.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Pavitra.
to do the vote of thanks.
Yeah, thank you, Deepti ma'am. Very good afternoon. Hope I'm audible.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Please open your video, ma. Unlock your video.
Yes. Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes, okay, you're audible.
Very good afternoon to all. On behalf of organizing team, I take great pleasure and honor to thank our founder chancellor, Thiru A.C. Shanmugam sir, our president engineer, Thiru A.C.S. Arun Kumar sir, our honorable secretary, Thiru A. Ravikumar sir, our vice chancellor, Professor Dr. S. Geeta Lakshmi ma'am, for all their encouragements throughout whatever we are coming across. I'm very much delighted to thank our guest lecturer, Professor Dr. R. Arihara Prakash sir, for enlightening his knowledge and for wonderful session today. Thank you so much, sir. I extend my thank to our beloved principal, Dr. C. V. Senthilnathan sir, and our vice principals, Dr. Rajalakshmi and Dr. Veena ma'am, for their tireless support. Last but not least, I thank all my faculty members and students for all their participation and making this particular session more grateful. Once again, thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you. Before the end, thanks for this Tamil Thai Vaalthu. I listened after so many years. Neeraarum Kadaludutta, I enjoyed that. Thank you so much again for that.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thanks, everybody.
What about the national anthem, ma? While we are winding, yeah.
Thank you, sir. It was a wonderful session. Hope our students will definitely take the five drivers what you have told, sir.
Thank you, the sixth one, most importantly. Thank you, Dr. Rajalakshmi. I would like to place in record your efforts and your perseverance and being as a key person to connect us. And I'm happy to see Senthilan sir here after so many years. I recollect now, and I feel now part of MGR University family. And I can extend whatever the support, whatever the things needed from my side. We belong to one profession, and thank you so much for each.
So actually, I would like to place one thing. Like, is it possible for us to do some joint projects, like joint research works between our university and your university?
Absolutely, we should rather this is the beginning that we have started with this webinar. Let's collaborate. I think after the webinar gets over, maybe we can start talking over. And we will decide. There are certain ongoing projects which is happening over here, over there as well. Multicentric research where we'll always gain more importance as we publish it.
Yes,
so
sir.
We can definitely plan out certain other things.
Yes, sir.
We can extend an MOU as well, if at all, for both of us. We can, under that MOU, we can do a lot of faculty exchange, research work collaboration, student exchange programs. So whatever the strengths that you have, our people can take it. And whatever we have, your people can come and
take it. It's mutual, sir. It's mutual. And
yes.
If it is not possible to have a proper MOV also, like...
Absolutely.
Research thing, kind of thing between...
That doesn't need any MOU also. It does not. It needs only... Correct. We can do that. Let's plan it ahead. We will keep in touch.
Sure, sir. Sure.
Definitely.
We will do it. Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you for sparing your valuable time for us, sir.
Before we wind up, participants, the feedback link has been posted for the certificate. Please fill in and get your e-certificates.
And share the feedback, any negative comments especially, so that I can change myself in the coming things, if at all.
Absolutely not. You won't be having not even one.
No. It is for development. First, criticism is always for growth.
What, Dharani, is there any national anthem? Like we have to?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
We all can sing if the video is also not there. I'm ready for it.
There, we have the...
Shubh naam jaage, tava shubh aashish maage,
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thanks for your patience.
Thank
listening.
You, sir.
We will keep in touch, sir.
Sure. Whatever definitely.
We will bring it in action. Let us
look
not
forward.
Wait in records.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
sir. Hey, class, ilada ide.
செமினார் ரெக்கார்ட் ஸ்டாப் பண்ணிடுங்க.
ஓகே மேம், ஓகே.